Hello everybody, hope you had a nice evening last night. We're dealing with some ice rain today, which I guess is kind of typical for the area. So everything is like raining and freezing, so it's a little scary out there. Very slippery, so if you're traveling in my region, please be careful. So yesterday we broke this guy in a him hauled around about what to do about it. We're going to go ahead and try to make two different points out of this broke. Probably go ahead and start with this one first. I'm not sure what I'm going to make just yet, but there might be a Cahokia in here. But it's chunky, so we're going to have to lose a lot of mass. We're good. Heavy quarter, 5/16 on the tip here. We could just do a stem type point also. Now we're 3/8 at the tip here, right at the thickest. So, probably do some indirect. I like doing indirect, especially on these smaller pieces, because it allows you to use things that you normally wouldn't be able to, at least at my skill level. So, I'm sure there's some guys out there that can do all this work with a billet and pressure flaker. I don't really like doing pressure flaking that much because it hurts my wrist. So we're going to do indirect, and I think we're going to use, yeah, let's play with this guy today. We haven't given this one much attention lately. It's a little tight. There we go, that loosened it up. I gotta cut this back. I like to keep it close to my leg, similar to the curved antler. I think it's just, it's less wobbly and it's got better control. This lace here. It's just what I like. I need to cut this back, but it's fine. It's fine for what we're doing today. That's what we're doing today. We'll see what we can do with this guy today. Sad, but we'll see what we can salvage out of it. My hand pad's getting a little rough here. My abrader is getting a little rough. So we'll go ahead and try to clean this up a little bit. I think my finger stopped it. It's a slightly different technique with this type. You don't really want your finger in the way. You just want to let it rip. Let it blow through. Which I don't like that much because it flings material everywhere. But it's effective, it works. I mean, just more tools to add to the toolbox. I'm no Jack Crafty when it comes to indirect, but I give it a go. If you guys are looking for a good indirect percussion channel, Jack Crafty is the way to go. I think he has a channel dedicated to abonapping. That's called Allergic Hobbit. It's also pretty good. He's really good. This point ends up still being chunky, we'll probably just make a stemmed point. Whoops. That wasn't part of the plan there. Not go through like I wanted to. There it goes. Okay. Okay, how about this one? And this one? Nope, and this one. Just to warn you, if a flake doesn't separate, it will tingle your fingers quite a bit. Tingle as in, ouch. Slap it like it owes your money. Here we got it a lot thinner. Now we are getting close to our size, so we gotta kind of think it through a little bit. Think through what we're doing here. Try not to mess it up any further. Do-do-do-do-do. on this guy. Whoops. Oop, I overshot right here. Yeah, it looks like I overshot on the other side. You can see it got nibbled out. Whoops. It's alright, we could shorten the point a little. Make up for that oopsie there. Possibly could have happened when I was abrading it. I probably got a little careless. It's got nice uniform thickness. I just gotta pick a shape here. Keep turning the tip. It'll help. If you guys are interested in this indirect system, there should be a video somewhere on my channel that I run through what this is, how I did it, what it is, stuff like that, if you are interested in knowing. this so I can see what I'm doing here. Need a little bit more contrast. Maybe we can make this a little corner notch. So here's where we're at. We could probably try a little corner notch. That might look cool. Yeah, we'll try corner notch. Fix my notcher though. We got a little beat up last time I used it. Oops. Got too aggressive on that one. It's okay. Got too greedy on how much pressure I had to. Never fails. I got one side freaking perfect and the other side broke. Go figure. It's alright. What a bummer. That's alright, we gotta just make it look like we did it on purpose now. That's too bad. Just the way it goes. I super screwed up that time. Darn it. Just had to mess with it. I think that'll do. There's the little corner notch. So here's the tip of that piece. I think it came up pretty nice. Give you some dimensions right quick, and then we'll start on the next one. And maybe we'll be able to knock them both out today. Overall length, 1 5/16. Width, 11/16. Thickness, 3/16 at the thickest. Yep, 3/16 at the thickest. So, there's that one. Not too bad, I don't think. I mean, I thought that looks pretty good. Alright, off to the next one. So here's this messed up piece. I think if we go corner to corner, that's the longest point. We'll see how it goes. Try to make that the tip. This is the base. Poke me. Don't bleed on a pretty white stone. Quit. Base looks pretty good. greedy. Tried to take too much off right there. Blew it out. That's okay. We're fighting the seam that I was talking about yesterday. Here's where we're at. We got it reduced down. Now we're gonna work on symmetry and cleaning up our greediness, so to speak. Possibly. If we get lucky. Okay. Ah, that darn seam. It's all right, we're just gonna have to get skinnier. Had a chunk blowout right there. Might make this one a Cahokia. Although we may not have the width for it. Might be too skinny. Maybe go with an Aggie. It's a little thick for an Aggie, but we'll try. We got options. even at the base. Here's where we're at. Gonna narrow it up a little bit. It's a little too wide. Might do a little indirect right there. See if that'll shoot across and clean that up. Bam, beat it. Hit that seam again. Shouldn't be much left anymore, but I got it. Rascal. I think we'll go for a Cahokia. Let's see what happens. If I can get that knob off, I think we'll be in good shape. Cool. Turn that off. We're almost done. Two out of three. One more to go. See if we can do it. I think that would pass as a Cahokia. Here we go, all finished up. I think that one came out pretty dang good. Give you guys some dimensions real fast, and I gotta get back to work. Start cutting to my eating time now. Let's see what we got here. We've got about 1 7/16", 3/4 inch wide, 3/16 thick at the thickest. But I think that's passable. And then we got our little corner notch here. Thanks for watching. Appreciate you. Bye.